Buddy, Mario 96 Luigi here. Just as a notice, you should be careful around hunters when they're down. Even though they're dying, sometimes when they're facing the ground, they'll attack you if you get too close. Like a leap. Like a final attack. Put these away. Take this one, I'll save first. I'll put the crank away for now and see if I can get the flamethrower. I'm pretty sure you have to use the flamethrower now because you won't be able to use it later. Because you can't progress without resting it somewhere else. Well, that's new. Well, it's been a while. The Black Tiger. Very intimidating when you look at it closely in detail.
Ugh.
There it is, another web spinner. You don't really need to fight that web spinner because it can just walk around it. Now to go back and get that crank because you're gonna need it for later. Chemical A and chemical B. I guess the doors are connected once the set flamethrower is set down. I'll leave the survival knife under the dog whistle. Nah, right here. Blue herb. Now I don't have to worry about health because I have so much. Crank. Take the shaft while I'm at it. Leaving some space to get more items. Now that I think about it, I'll leave the shotgun shells. Guess there's gonna be quite a few more items further down. You will have to wonder who set up these architects, well, aside from Trevor. Because how would the person get on the other side of that door if it's blocked by caves? Yeah, on Jill's walkthrough, I went the harder way, all the way back, when I could have just went in that shorter way. First date's brave, if I remember correctly. If I remember correctly, you don't need the crank anymore after this. Playing Resident Evil Village is gonna be so fun. I'll do that later. If you guys wonder why I do that, it's because I like doing it like that organized. I'll keep it on me just in case. I'll have room once I put the shaft mechanic in the machine. Here we go, into the depths. Okay guys, I'll end the video here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next part.